Hi everyone, welcome back. We're going to go ahead and do another partial derivative problem. This one looks like the following: f of x, y, z equals x e to the y plus y e to the z plus z e to the x. Okay, so as always with partial derivative problems, we need to realize that our answer is going to include the number of equations of the variables that we have in our problem. So in other words, we have three variables in our equation, x, y, and z, so our answer is going to have three parts: the partial derivative with respect to x, and then with respect to y, and then with respect to z. So we have three things we need to do. We'll do it one at a time. The notation looks like this. The partial derivative of f, and we get the f from here, with respect to x, and then the partial derivative of f with respect to y, and then the partial derivative of f with respect to z. So those are our three parts. We're going to go ahead and start with the partial derivative with respect to x. And the way that we do that, when we're looking at this equation and we're taking the derivative with respect to x, all that means is that we're going to hold y and z, the other two variables in this equation, constant. So let's go term by term. So x e to the y. If we're holding y as a constant, then e to the y will also be a constant. E, if you plug in e to the 1 in your calculator, it's something like 2.7, whatever. E is a constant, so e to the y is also a constant, which means that this actually looks like a coefficient, like 2x, right? 2 is a constant, or 12x, 12 is a constant. The derivative of 2x, right, would be 2. This is the same thing. E to the y is like that 2, it's like the constant. So when you take the derivative of x e to the y, and e to the y is a constant, it's like 2x just becomes 2, x e to the y is just going to become e to the y. That's all that's going to be left. So we'll say e to the y, that's the derivative of the first term here. Then we'll go ahead and look at this term. This term, because it has no x variable in it, it's actually just going to reduce to 0. And the way that we know that is if you think about it, e is a constant, e raised to z, which we're also holding constant because we're taking the derivative with respect to x. E to the z is going to become a constant, and of course y is a constant because we're holding y and z constant when we're looking at x. So this whole thing is actually going to reduce to something like 5 or 2, and the derivative of any constant is just 0. So this part is 0, and the way that we know that just simply, and we'll get to memorizing these things, is that there's no x term in this, so we don't actually have to deal with it at all. So then let's move on to the third term, z e to the x, and I know e is kind of a complicated thing when it comes to derivatives and antiderivatives, but you'll remember that if we were going to take the derivative of, let's say 2e to the 3x, right? I'm going to go ahead, so for comparison's sake, and write a 1 in here, because that 1 is implied, right? It's 1x, it's the same as x, so that's implied. So I'm going to draw a direct comparison between z e to the 1x and 2e to the 3x. So this, if we were going to take the derivative of this guy, we would multiply the 3 by the 2, so it would be 2 times 3 is 6, e to the 3x. Because when it's e, we always leave this coefficient 3 the same. We don't subtract 1 from it. It doesn't disappear. It just stays what it was in the original problem. We just multiply it out here. So it's going to be the same way here. Z is like the coefficient 2, and 1 here is the coefficient on the x, like the 3. So if we took the derivative of this, we would multiply 1 by z. So we would just get z, and then we'd be left with e to the 1x, right? But we don't have to write the 1, it's just implied, so we can get rid of that. So the derivative of this is actually just ze to the x. So we can write down here ze to the x. Let's go ahead and do the partial derivative with respect to y, and hopefully that'll give you a better understanding of the partial derivative with respect to x as well. So again, we're going to go term by term through this with respect to y. So let's look at this one first. You can see here, when we took the derivative of this, when the x was the exponent on the e here, now this is the same thing with y as the exponent on the e. So this is actually going to stay exactly the same, just like this did. We brought ze to the x straight down here, and we demonstrated how to do that over here. That stayed exactly the same. This is in the same exact form. You can see the x is the same as the z, the e is still there, and the y is now the coefficient on the exponent where the x was. So that's going to stay exactly the same, x, e to the y. And then we look at this term for y, and it is exactly the same as when we were looking at this one for x, right? Because here we had e to a different variable, and we had the single x. Now we have e to a different variable and the single y when we're taking it with respect to y. And we just brought the e to the y straight down here because the e to the y was like a coefficient on the x, and the x dropped away, we were left with e to the y. Here, the y is going to drop away, and we're going to be left with e to the z. So this is actually going to be plus e to the z. And then this is going to go away because there's no y in this term here. It's just z e to the x. There's no y at all. Remember, up here, with respect to x, this term disappeared because there was no x in it, so it just becomes 0. Because there's no y in here, this is going to become 0. So we're going to leave it off. So then, you can probably start to guess, when we're looking at the derivative with respect to z, let's go term by term here, right? There's no z in here, so this is going to become 0. It goes away completely, there's no z. This one, now we have the z as the exponent on the e, right? And when that happened in the previous two, right, we had x here on the e, y here on the e, now we have z on the e. And that, so this whole thing, this whole term here, is going to come down and stay exactly the same, just like this one did, and just like this one did. So we're going to have y, e to the z, and then dealing with this term here, this is going to be the same as this term and this term, right? The z is going to drop away, and we're going to be left with e to the x, because e to the x is like a coefficient on that z. So we are left with e to the x. And so you can see how all three of these take a similar form, and I guess I could flip these two terms so you could see, but we've got, you know, z e to the x e to the y, and y e to the z all came down. E to the y, e to the z, and e to the x, which were like coefficients on those other variables. And then in each one, the term that didn't include the variable that we were currently working on was dropped, because that ultimately reduces to 0 as a constant. So here's your three partial derivatives. All three of these need to be included in the answer. And we'll do a couple more problems so you guys can get an example, but this whole thing here is the final answer for this problem.